her.
Ja, tusind tak. Det er perfekt.
Skivt på.
Ja. Men slet ikke ligesom det der, vel? Altså, når sådan man sidder, og så skal man... Altså, der får jeg fandme ondt i håndledet, når det er sådan, jeg skal lave den her.
I've set up my hammock a ton of times, so it didn't take long. Morten is new in the world of hammocking, so I decided to lend him a hand. I realized my help wasn't appreciated, so I began to set up the camp tower. Soon after, Bertram joined me. We were all set up, and it was time to get that beer.
Det var den kunne lukke dig.
fornemmelse.
Nå, jamen, det dufter da godt i hvert fald.
We had cabbage and roast pork for dinner. We only ate half of it, so I covered the pork with a pot. When the rest of us was getting ready for a good night's sleep, Bjørn, Morten's dog, tilted the pot and ate what we were supposed to have for breakfast. Bjørn is a terrier and naughty by nature.
Tre eller fire projekter på hver væg, ja. Og indbygget totalt super fedt, sådan 5-1 surround. Og så står det og kører lige stille derinde. Ja. Men det her, det havde jeg.
This morning, the wind would be the most calm on the trip, so we decided to take a walk to the coast to see what the fjord could provide us. Both the air and water is about 4-5 degrees Celsius. This is the Pacific oyster, an invasive oyster that can be found on only a few centimeters of water, where the native European flat oyster lives a bit deeper. Today, we preferred the invasive species.
I think the lunch is saved. It's so cold. Look, Moose.
Mm, det synes jeg godt. Især den sidste, den her fod der, der binder til.
Mm.
A power nap was to become routine, at least for Morten and me, that is. When Morten went out searching for the perfect shot, and Bertram was spoon carving, I made myself a chair. If I don't have a backrest, it only takes a few hours before I start laying halfway down, supporting on an elbow. When I get sore in my arm and shoulder, my hammock starts calling me, and I often end up in bed way too early.
Prøv at se, hvem der kommer der, Bjørn. Børn og musen.
Hey! Hey! Oh. Ah. Hey! Ui, 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 musen og bjørn! Hey! Hej, hej!
Jeg prøver at stoppe der, i første omgang.
Det var nemmere end, ja.
Så, det bliver, hvis det bliver det fandme, så kan det ikke være det.
That's a good one. But now, what are you actually looking for?
Yeah, I'm just looking for a nice big bird because the drill I brought is a bit on the big side, so we don't damage a small tree. This one can take it. And another way you can tap it is by taking a branch. I can't reach a birch branch, but if you take a birch branch and cut it off like here, and then tie the bottle to the branch, put it on, put a string around, tie it on here, and maybe take the string down to the ground so it stays like this instead of hangs like this so it will drip out. That's a good way, but it doesn't give near as much sap as if you drill it, but this is better for the tree. So,
but will the tree actually survive when you drill a hole and stuff?
Yeah, it's no problem because we will put a plug, put it in, and the tree will grow around it. It will be part of it at some point.
Ja. Ej, det ser godt ud.
One drip every second or something like that. I have no idea how long it will take to fill up that bottle, but I'm looking forward to it. Do you think we'll get it half full?
Yeah.
Before night?
Yeah, I think that's no problem. Maybe we'll see. in a couple of hours we'll go look at it again. Sometimes the hole will stop automatically.
Yeah.
But drips the most in the beginning, and then it slowly takes off.
And then when we come back, we make that pluck, and then the tree will just like heal the little wound.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
And then next year you find another tree to tap from, and maybe after a couple of years you can go back to this tree again, but just give it some rest for a year or so.
Friske hav, kigge fisk.
Ja. Når vi diskuterer, så får du nogle af dem, der er lidt mere lige til. Okay.
Den burde være lun. Den er varm. De andre her, de burde være lige til at tage. Så du må hellere, du må vælge først. Hvilken en du vil have? Jeg har også smagt. Ja, det kan jeg forstå. Jeg laver nogle flere dog.
Bare nice.
Ja, også bare uden noget.
Ja, jeg kom lige i tanke om, at vi fik ingen...
So it's completely filled up with birch sap, and we decided to put another pot so that tomorrow morning we will have, what is it, 2 liters or 1 liter?
Yeah, 2 liters in that one.
Two liters. And now we are going to taste. For me, it's the first time I'm tasting fresh birch sap. Maybe you should start. You're the
you're the
master.
You're the virgin, so you go ahead.
But is it? It's like almost like water, but a little bit sweet.
Yeah, at the end, it becomes sweet, right? Very cold and very fresh.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, let's hope this one is full. And then we have like almost 3 liters of fresh tapped birch sap. Yeah, let's go.
Whenever Bjorn has a chance, he steals Moosen's basket. He had a haircut a month ago, and the weather wasn't on his side. I slept miserably. I cramped together in shock several times, as it sounded like the forest was falling down on me from violent gusts of wind. In the fall, one of the trees I was hanging from fell. Luckily, it fell on my side, as it was side-heavy seeking the light towards the sea I was lying next to. The tree had leaves and bark and looked fresh, but from the ground and 20 centimeters up, it was completely rotten, I found out. The feeling from that experience came back to me, I guess.
David Blaine.
Du. Det er simpelthen bare lært det her.
sig selv på en måde, hvis man kan sige det sådan.
Lækkert.
All over the northern hemisphere, it's been used for curing cancer.
Mm.
From Siberia to Northern America to Scandinavia, all
with,
around.
With tea or just eating like that?
Like tea,
huh.
And extract.
Mm.
And for its for other purposes, health benefits.
But all I have used it for is catching an ember.
Yeah.
But is that this part or the because it looks a little different. I think mine at home is a more brown like this color.
Uh-huh.
Is that underneath the black or is it just everything here that can catch a spark?
No, the best thing is to catch a spark is the orange stuff.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So this part that's underneath here.
Yeah, because it's like small fibers.
Yeah.
So easier catched than this. But the good stuff in the fungo is the birch sap.
Yeah.
The birch tree get an injury from a branch that break off or something, and the fungus can attack the tree.
Mm.
And then the tree tries to protect itself with its good benefits in the birch sap. So this fungus is compromised birch sap.
Oh. So we do not harm the tree by taking the chaga.
No, no. The tree thinks it's good that we remove the chaga. But if you want to remove, if you want to keep some chaga on the tree so you can harvest it again, don't take all of it off. Mm. Yeah.
Now we just need to cut it to see what's inside.
Sit it
mm-hmm.
So for a tea we can use everything,
mm-hmm.
and for catching an ember,
mm.
which part is best?
Yeah, the inside.
So the brown
yeah.
part is good for catching an ember.
Yeah, but the most potent for tea is the black stuff.
Okay, so we just need to get some of the black stuff in the tea.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can use this one for catching embers.
Yeah, you can use all of it for tea, and you can use it for catching embers afterwards.
Okay, how long do we need to boil the thing?
If it's for health purposes, you cannot boil it. But if it's just for the taste, you can just boil
okay.
ahead.
And how much, more or less? Yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah, half of this.
Okay.
Then you can reuse it like five times or so, until it doesn't get any color. Yeah, the smaller pieces, the faster
okay.
It will brew the tea, right?
Yeah, great.
Jeg har læst, at det skal være for levende, for at det er godt.
Okay. Yeah. So, most of the time, it's best to take this chaga from birch trees that are still alive, because if they are dead, there's not so much of the good stuff in the chaga. So, and it's also found on popples, I think it's called in English. Other trees, but again, it's the birch sap that gives the health benefit. So, it should be found on birch trees that are still alive.
And the older the birch tree, the better.
Okay, cool.
The older the fungus, the better.
Mm. Oh, det er tyk. Det er jo lige så tyk som kaffe. Jeg kan være lidt disciplineret omkring måltiderne. Mm. Finder hun. Åh, musen. Bjørn. Ja. Det drypper fuldstændig. Det drypper nærmest hurtigere, end da vi satte det op.
Ja, det gør det.
That was really nice. It's almost full, except for like a centimeter of fresh birch sap. And now we are going to put that in our bottles. And then, we're going to show how we close the hole. So we can like stop the bleeding of the tree and it can recover. Yeah, that's really nice.
But this tree has a nice inward curve, so we don't need to have a tab in it, otherwise you can carve a tab like that, put it in and get out from the tree. But here it has a slight inward curve,
yeah,
and it also protects the sap from rain because it falls from a higher place on the tree.
præcis.
That was nice. I mean, not brilliant photos, but just nice to get a little close to these deer for the first time on this peninsula. They are still out there grassing, but I couldn't get any closer, and if I would get closer, I would definitely scare them because I had to go to the open, and there's absolutely no reason for that. So no.
That is nice to see a campfire.
Besides the treats, the dog had raw chicken and dry food every day. They were in no need. I woke up to the sound of Bjorn crying. Morten was out photographing. He came over to me to be comforted, but Moosen wasn't having it. I made room for him on my jacket, and he could finally relax and get some sleep again.
Yeah.
til alle de harpiks.
Ja. Jeg kan ryge hende det her til kvæs. Jeg var sgu glad for mig, da.
Han ville have været oppe i grønnen. Det fik han sgu ikke lov til at bæse lidt, da.
Nej.
Nej, der er du en satanmuser.
Det der, det er noget, han kan lide. At få solen i ansigtet. Mm. Prøv at høre. Snokker han.
Jeg har også været glad for at grave.
Jo, jo.
Det er bare, at man skal fra.